Hello student, good morning. Welcome back for the new topic, the integrated pest management of paddy. So let's see the major pest of paddy. So it's very important crop in cereals that have the great value in the India. For the major growing states are the south region, even also the some part of our Maharashtra, mostly in like Konkan region, in Vidarbha region, that many farmers that cultivated the paddy crop. In fact, on that paddy, so the many pests that attacking and that responsible to reduce the yield. So the major pest that highlighting on slide, so first one is the paddy stem borer, green leaf hopper, round plant hopper, some galmies, swarming caterpillar, rice hispa, some cutworms, caseworm, thrips, and mealybugs. It means some are the some defoliators, some are the plant suckers, some are the borer insect. So these are all that major pest on paddy. So during the examination point of view, suppose the question arise that to write any two pest of paddy, so the mention any one or two example in your examination. So first of all, so this integrated pest management practices that use in the paddy crop. First one is that the pest monitoring. So in the previous lecture already we learned that pest, how to doing the pest monitoring in the field. This pest monitoring that practice is implemented through the two equipments or two tools, namely that pheromone traps and the light trap. Here I am showing you this pheromone trap that one farmers that installed in field for why? For monitoring of paddy stem borer. Even also the here that one light trap that installed or fixing that positioning of pheromone and light traps to during in appropriate stage of crop. Why? Suppose on the basis of this prediction point of view that required this stage, so we have to predict the further infestation. Okay, in this type of this all activity, the State Department of Agriculture can initiate this action at a strategic location at village level as per the different types of some tools that installing like the pheromone traps. So generally required five traps per hectare may be used the monitor the yellow stem borer and some moth population incidence recording purpose. This pheromone trap is essential. Second one, this light trap, that light trap or any other light trap we can use, so that operated by for 2 hours in evening or in night time to observing and to record the data of phototropic insect, even also the some plant sucker insect that attracted towards, some moth also attracted towards, and this all that kerosene water pan. So here that attracted moths are that fallen inside this water tank. So this is the initial stage that to controlling of this pest through this the monitoring. Okay, so now the again some sweep nets are available to use that for a visual observation, and also the water pans also be used to assess or estimate the population of different insect pest, and some are the biological control also that to determine, and on the basis of this all this data, all recorded data, that we have to use the need based pesticide or the recommended dose and use against that particular pest. So that's why this pest monitoring program is very important during the pest controlling point of view. Now, which are these some important like some practices again used? The first one is the cultural practices. Okay, so in this cultural practices, what here I am showing you some picture. There are some pest. This one is this leaf hopper. Okay, it's a suckers pest. This is one the like the borer, stem borer. That here, that a second picture that is the damage caused by this stem borer. So how these cultural practices that implement, first one is to growing the pest resistant variety or moderately resistant variety generally used or recommended. So why in the further infestation may be reduced by using this type of the resistant varieties. If the farmers that growing susceptible variety, so there is the much more population or incidence of this type of the pest are arise. So that's why in cultural practices, the resistant variety is generally used or recommended. Second one, at the time of the sowing or preparation of this nursery seedlings, so use healthy seeds that will arising for the healthy nursery. That means to get the more resistant plant or healthy plant during the transplanting or during the transplanting in the main field point of view. Second, third one practice is use regulating nitrogenous application to avoid. Why? Because to nutritional resurgence of plant hoppers and some leaf hoppers, this pest incidence will that comes due to the nitrogenous fertilizer application. So we have to again use the careful timing of the planting, that time do that proper timing of planting is we have to fix it, and then we have to use for the sowing purpose. Uprooting the stubbles with the deep flowing soon after the harvest, during the land preparation time, you have to use this type of the practices. If the some stubbles or some like a previous crop stubbles that are present in the field, so we have to collect it. That means the sanitation is required, and after that the collection, this all the stubbles we have to throw out the field and burnt it properly. And finally, that gives the deep plowing, and due to this deep plowing, what may be the hidden stages present in soil, so like the pupa, okay, like a larva, okay, here I am writing about the pupa, and okay, and some like a larva that generally that destroy through this the deep plowing. Harvesting of a crop to ground level, so this practice is also generally used to against the yellow stem borer and some gall midge fly. Here those that insect name are highlighted the red in a color, so this are the major pests that use against the different practices. Alternate wetting and drying practices also the recommended in paddy field against the paddy stem borer, even also like this like leaf hopper purpose. Raise pre-crop kharif growing sesbania, these are the some trap crop or that some crop that you have to use for the 45 days old crop in soil during land preparation, where whatever that is possible, so we have to raise them, okay, or grow them. Now the mechanical practices of this paddy in so first one is the hand collection practices, like a collection of egg masses. If the tip of the seedlings that presence of egg masses of a stem borer or even also the seedlings that are damaged by this larval pest larva, so we have to remove it and destroy, okay, or that we have to place in bamboo cages for conservation of biological control, okay. So this is one day, this is for the biological control point of view. If that we have to control this the pest, so we have to collect it affected plant or egg masses or larval infested plant parts, so we have to properly destroy them. Even also that removal and destruction of pest infested plants, okay. So during the transplanting, that time this mechanical practices generally use that clipping of rice seedling at the tip during the transplanting. Why? Minimizing the carrier of the rice hispa case worm, rice hispa, okay. Next one, case worm and stem borer. If in nursery bed these seedlings are affected and at the tip of there is the presence of some egg masses, so there is a chances to further infestation or to increase the infestation in our main field. That's why this type of the clipping the rice seedlings, so we have to remove these egg masses, so that will the control the next population. That's why they serve from the main seed bed to transplanting field, this mechanical practices is very important. Now, the again, some are the rope dragging method here that use in case of this, the paddy field. Rope dragging, that use the coir rope, okay, in rice crop. So why? Generally in the rice, so here that some I'm picture showing you, these are this the pollen cases. Here also that the pollen cases. So these are the nothing but it's a case swarm infestation, that cutting of leaf tips, cutting of this leaf blade, cutting of the leaves, through this the infestation by this case swarm or cutworm. So how, if this rope dragging method, when that passes around the field or so on the surface of the field, so this all dislodge case swarm or cutworm, that even also the some leaf holder larva are dislodge on the surface of water and remove from this main field, okay, and after this collected this case swarm and cutworm infested plant parts, you have to destroy it in kerosinized water. Okay, here that some like recommended dose here I mentioned. So that will control by this rope. Okay, so this is one the mechanical practices. Now again, the third one, this practices use in paddy crop against the different pest in paddy. So here the picture I'm showing you, this is the trichocard, and here on that trichocard, that what may be the eggs present, this eggs of this wasp, that known as a Trichogramma chelonis wasp, this one adult of Trichogramma chelonis, when these eggs are hatched and this adult comes out, is to start the searching of the host egg. This is the host egg. Here that example mentioned, Trichogramma japonicum and Trichogramma chelonis. These are the two important species that use against the many larval pest eggs. So release in the field of paddy at the rate of 1 lakh per hectare, when the on the appearance of egg masses of yellow stem borer or any leaf holder or any lepidopteran pest in the field. So this Trichogramma japonicum and Trichogramma chelonis, that to search this type of the eggs, okay, and to lay inside the host eggs, okay, and finally the further infestation or further population are totally controlled by these two agents, that Trichogramma japonicum, Trichogramma chelonis. This is are the egg parasitoid of different larval pest. Always remember, Trichogramma japonicum, Trichogramma chelonis, it is nothing but it is the bioagents, and these bioagents are the egg parasitoid. So again, here I am mentioned against the rice gall midge insect or pest purpose, the Plactigaster oryzae, this is also the one bioagents used to control the gall midge fly. Okay, this is also the second example of biological control. Again, third practices that given in biological control, some are the again biological control agents such as the spiders, old spider, some myriad bugs, even also the damsel flies, dragon flies, some coccinellid, that means the ladybird beetle, some apentelis. Okay, so even also the Telenomus remus, Trichogramma, Bracon inhibitor, Bracon brevicornis, Plactigaster oryzae, these are the all the some other the important biological control agent used against different pests. And this type of the bio agents are very important, and we have to conserve it for the minimizing the further infestation of paddy. So always remember any two or three examples that to need to write in exam. Okay, now the last one in chemical control method in IPM. So what may be the need best or some judicious pesticide available? So that time you have to use the same pesticide and that apply it in safely. That recommended dose required here that I mentioned, some gall midge fly purpose, carbofuran at the rate of 40 kilogram per hectare, or we can use the forate granules or forate insecticide at the rate of 12.5 kg per hectare during the nursery bed or during the seedling preparation time. This type of the gall midge purpose or gall midge pest incidence purpose, this type of the pesticides use carbofuran and forate. Okay, for the stem borer insect, stem borer pest controlling point of view, same here, carbofuran 3% that carbofuran granules at the rate of 25,000 gram. Okay, to 666,600 gram per hectare. That doses are different in different insecticide. Okay, so that use against this stem borer again are the monocrotophos pesticide also that in given in per hectare 625 ml or to 1250 ml per hectare. Okay, so again the leaf folder, brown plant hopper, even also the WBPH white back plant hopper, leaf folder spray, cut-up hydrochloride 4% granules, cut-up even chloroporyphos at the rate of the 25,000 gram per hectare, even for the brown plant hopper or white back plant hopper spray, imidacloprid 70% vegetable granule at the rate of 30 to 35 gram per hectare. So dear student, these are the many pesticide that use against the different pest of paddy. So in examination point of view, at least two or three pesticide mention against the different pest, and always that we have to write the different type of pesticide and with its dose. So these are the all about this IPM practices of paddy. So thank you very much. This